Biden now, the real Biden, on religion. He's not in favor of religion. He can talk all he wants, but what they've done to Catholics and what they've done to evangelicals, what they've done to everybody is a disgrace.
Yep. Joe Biden, who is obviously a religious guy. I'm an atheist, but he's a religious guy. He goes to church, which I've always thought is a good way to demonstrate that you're religious, is actually going to the house of worship for your religion. Trump, on the other hand, has not been to church since he held a Bible up upside down while having people beaten all around him. And to prove his bona fides when it comes to religion, he says he doesn't support religion. What he's doing to the Catholics, to everyone, really bad, really bad. Oh, that is highly detailed. That's very specific. Clearly, this is something that bothers you, that you think a lot about. It has always bothered me how little Donald Trump needs to do to get religious conservatives to still believe that he's one of them. Like, this is a guy who clearly has less respect for organized religion than most atheists do, and yet it does not bother them. And just to really prove this point, I want to remind you of something that happened way back in 2015, and I cannot believe that's like 8 years ago. But
wow, yeah.
Here is a video of Donald Trump being asked one of the easiest, like just teeing him up answers when it comes to religion, and he had nothing. Take a look.
You mentioned the Bible. You've been talking about how it's your favorite book, and you said, I think last night in Iowa, some people are surprised that you say that. I'm wondering what one or two of your most favored Bible verses are.
I wouldn't want to get into it, because to me that's very personal. You know, when I talk about the Bible, it's very personal, so I don't want to get into verses.
There's no verse that means a lot to you that you think about or cite.
The Bible means a lot to me, but I don't want to get into specifics.
Even to cite a verse that you like.
No, I don't want to do that.
Old Testament guy or New Testament guy?
Probably equal. I think it's just an incredible, the whole Bible is an incredible.
Look.
Classic.
I'm an atheist. That's obviously not supposed to appeal to me. But if you're a Christian and you listen to that, I want you with a straight face to say that that guy gives a single damn about the Bible, that he's maybe ever read any of it. Please, I want you to say that with a straight face. That guy does not care about religion at all. And by the way, in that, he's similar to a lot of rich people. When you have $1 billion, how much do you think people care about religion at that point, for the most part? But he's not even good at hiding it. He can't even do that thing that most politicians, godless politicians, do. And yet it doesn't bother them at all. And that just proves how empty their supposed centering of religious values is to their politics. That Absolutely. They will follow a guy like that with all of his issues of the affairs and the talking about assaulting women and all that. He doesn't care about any of it. It should bother them, but it doesn't.
No, but more insane than that, John, is that they believe he is the savior. He is the whatever, King David or whatever king, whatever rapey king there was in the Bible. Again, haven't read that much of it, but I do know, unlike Donald Trump, the Old and the New Testament. He clearly doesn't know there was an Old Testament and New Testament. Watch his face. He doesn't even know. He's like, equal, you know, like he doesn't
just
know.
Choose one. Just he choose one.
Exactly. But he doesn't know. He didn't even know they were divided. He didn't even know that that was part of the Bible. That's why the cult of Trump is so powerful and so strong. It wins out of any of this fake religiosity that he does not have, the fake morals, because Christians who still support Trump convince themselves that because he is a walking sort of walking sinner who commits crimes as he breathes, you know, covets everyone's wife, would murder someone on Fifth Avenue, maybe has, that somehow that makes him the most holy of them all. Trump greater than Jesus in every single, push comes to shove, Trump greater than Jesus. We did back in 2015, we basically did a joke sketch for Newsbrook that was if Jesus came back to Earth, MAGA and Trump supporters would be no. We don't. You're a third party spoiler candidate. Bye.
100%. Yeah, you know, like I think in the myth of like the Antichrist, how he's gonna come and he's gonna be super popular and he's gonna win over, I think, a lot of Christians. I think that's the idea.
Right.
And it's always, it has never really made a ton of sense to me why like this evil figure would be able to do that, but it's because they can't tell. They have no capacity whatsoever to tell who's legit and who's clearly conning them. So I now believe that that portion of the Bible probably prophetic, and we'll be seeing it soon.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.